whole lot of trouble. Pocoyo and Ellie and Pato.
Hi.
What's that you're playing?
Marbles.
Let's see. You need to get your marble into that small hole right there in the middle, right? And how is everyone doing? What about you, Pocoyo? That's a special black super marble. Oh, I'm sorry, Pocoyo. You almost had it. Well, whose turn is it now? Wait! What's happening?
Yay!
Yes, Pocoyo, but how did your marble move all on its own? I think you've discovered a black hole. It'll suck up anything nearby. And you know what that means, don't you? Pocoyo, this is no time for dancing. Now come on, get away from that hole. Good idea, Pato. Grab that tree. Hold on, everyone. This is rather funny, isn't it? But I'm afraid we have to get Ellie out somehow. Can anyone switch on the light? Well, that's a relief. Everything seems to be fine, except for one minor detail. All the colors are reversed. Pato, you're not yellow anymore. Now you're purple. And Ellie, now you're green. You'd like everything to go back to normal, wouldn't you? Well, maybe there's a way. Are you thinking about how to get back to your world, Pocoyo? Well, you know, maybe your black super marble is the key. Maybe it can take you back home. Yes, Ellie, that's it. In this world, Pocoyo's black marble would be white. Now what? There you go, a white hole. Jump in, everyone. But Pato, don't you want to be yellow again? This certainly isn't your world. You're all made of paper. You'd better find that marble. Good job, Pato. Oh, my. You're balloons now. You're back home, guys. You didn't leave anything behind, did you? That's a good question, Pato. What should you do with it? It looks like Pocoyo has an idea. A rocket? Oh, I see. Well, then I'd better start a countdown. Ready? 3, 2, 1, blast off! Well, look at that. It's a magical nighttime. Mm-hmm. See you soon.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
What should we play today, Pocoyo? Yes, I see it too, Pocoyo. Something shiny. I'm not sure Pocoyo knows what that is. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what this is?
It's a key!
Key!
Exactly, a key! And who knows what surprises it might unlock? How exciting! Yes, and you know, if I didn't know better, I'd say that was the kind of key they once used to open old pirates' treasure chests.
Treasure? Treasure! Treasure! Treasure, treasure, treasure! Treasure, treasure, treasure!
That's amazing. It looks like... It is a keyhole, Pocoyo.
Waiter?
Give it a try. Well, I don't know about treasure, but I've never seen anything like that before.
Hello. Treasure? Treasure! Treasure?
Well, there's no treasure here. Sorry for waking you, sleepy bird.
Key. Treasure. Treasure! Key! Treasure! Treasure! Treasure!
Hey, another keyhole. I didn't realize we had a basement.
Treasure! Treasure! Treasure, treasure, treasure. Treasure! Battle!
Surprised to see us, Pato?
Treasure battle!
Exciting! Go on, give it a try. Whee!
Now they're on the bottom of the sea. Well, this looks like it's as far as you can go, doesn't it? I don't believe it! Look!
Treasure!
You know, I think it just might be. Nothing would surprise me after what I've seen today. Go ahead, Pocoyo. Open it. I wonder what's inside. Sweets? Toys? What could the treasure be? What is it? What's there? Will all of you go and look and tell me what's in the treasure chest?
It's lots of keys!
Treasure!
This is the best treasure of all, isn't it? After the fun we've had today. Keep opening doors, asking questions, and exploring your world. That is the key to it all. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pocoyo and Pato. What have you got there? Oh, a comic book. Those are some huge, scary monsters. I bet they make scary noises, too. Can you make a scary noise like a monster? Come on, everyone, let's make monster noises. Yay! That's really scary! What was that? A toy car! I think you'd better get out of its way, Pocoyo. I wonder where it's going. I think Pato is more interested in monsters than the car. Keep up, Pocoyo. Goodness. A toy city. Amazing. It looks like it's made of blocks. Pato, you've got to see this. You'll love it. Giants! What are you two thinking? I see. Pocoyo will be the monkey monster and Pato the terrifying dragon monster. Hang on a minute, Pocoyo. Pato's right, Pocoyo. He's the dragon monster and you're the monkey monster.
Okay.
Very good, Pocoyo.
What's this? Some little creatures? Oh, he hasn't seen them. Pocoyo can't see the poor little creatures because he's having so much fun being scary. Oh, dear. I think Pocoyo and Pato are scaring them. Now, Pato, wait! Oh, no! Oh, dear. Pato, that's enough now. Pato, Pocoyo, stop the game. This is really going too far. Pato, Pocoyo. Oh, dear. They're making so much noise, they can't hear me. Can you shout stop with me? It's our only chance. Ready?
Stop playing!
Pocoyo, those buildings that you're knocking down, there are things that live inside them. You can't see them because they're hiding. Look over there, inside that building. See? I'm afraid you've given them quite a scare.
Friends!
They're still afraid of you, Pocoyo. You've smashed up their city through your monster play. You need to put things right. What do all of you think? Should Pocoyo and Pato rebuild the city? Great idea! Yes, they should! Ah, now that's better! Come back, little creatures. No need to be frightened. Good as new. Only, where's Pato? Built them a fairground, too. How nice. Pato, you are the fairground. Well, that is original. Hooray for Pocoyo and Pato. Hooray for being considerate. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Oh. What's this?
Duh.
Yes, I wonder what's behind it. Do you think Pocoyo should open it and find out?
Yes,
open it.
A door to the sky? Now that's unusual.
Pato!
Pato's gone, look!
Oh my! I wonder what happened to the sky. Yeah, I think Pato wants to keep watching the fish. Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Pato went? Potato, there you are. Pocoyo is looking for you. Wait. Oh, Pocoyo, you just missed him. Pato, wait. Oh, dear. Pocoyo, I'm afraid you just missed him again. Oh, my. That is one strange door. Try again. Did you see him?
Pato?
Yes, he was just there. There he is again! Oh my! Another door! More doors? Oh dear! Now, Pocoyo, you can't give up. That sounded familiar. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who made that sound?
Pato!
I believe you're right. It sounded like Pato. Perhaps you ought to get some help, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Pato, Pato.
Hooray! You found him. What's that, Ellie? You're working on something. What could Ellie be working on that's so important? That's what Ellie was busy with. She was preparing a party. What fun! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for not giving up! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Pocoyo.
I'm not Pocoyo. Super Inventor Pocoyo.
Oh, I see. You're a Super Inventor. Super Inventor Pocoyo.
Yay, 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 yay.
And would you show us any of your inventions?
Ta-da!
Wow, that's such a great gadget. What's it for?
Oh! Broken!
Oh, I see. It's broken.
Wait!
There you have another new device. What's this one for?
Not finished.
Pocoyo, I wonder if you might have any other inventions? Maybe one that is finished or works? Oh, okay, that way. Wow! That's amazing! A super invention! Whoa! It's a teletransporting machine! And would you give us a demonstration?
Pato!
Great! Pato, Pocoyo has built a machine and we'd love to try it. We were wondering whether you'd, if you'd like to help us. I see. This is another one of your gadgets. Incredible! It's a mind-reading machine. Reading Pato's mind, we'll find out if he wants to take part in this experiment.
Pato says yes!
I'm afraid we've run out of volunteers. Well done, Ellie! We've got our volunteer back!
Yay!
That's weird. He should have arrived by now. Oh no! The machine has a virus and Pato is stuck inside. We've got to help him get out. Caterpillar, we need to bail Pato out. As soon as Pocoyo signals us, we need to push this button and bring our friends back. Well done. We just need to find Pato now. But this world is huge. We're never going to find him. Oh, there he is. And the virus is after him. Run, Pato, run! Virus! It's fallen apart! Oh no! It's getting put back together! What do you mean, Pocoyo?
Oh, it's time to signal Caterpillar.
All right, I'll take care of it. Caterpillar, do you remember what Pocoyo explained before? Good. Now you need to push the button. No, no, focus, Caterpillar. This is really important. You must press the button. No, Caterpillar, not that button. You must trigger the red switch, the one marked with the arrow. No, Caterpillar, you need to focus. Come on, Caterpillar, the big button, the red one. That's right, Caterpillar, the red button. No, no, Caterpillar, you need to press the button. No? But Caterpillar, we need to bring our friends back. Phew! Just in time. This has been really exciting. Oh, the virus, it's still there. Well done! That's much better! Great! Now let's keep enjoying new adventures!
Oh look! There are Pocoyo and Ellie! They're out for a ride!
Hello, Pocoyo! Hello, Ellie!
There's nothing like a relaxing ride on a nice day to make you feel wonderful and bring friends together. Oh. Oh my! It seems like Ellie and Pocoyo's relaxing little ride together is becoming a race.
And there's Pato!
But where's he going? Aha! There he is, I see. Pato wants Ellie and Pocoyo to have a real race. How exciting! Gather round, everyone. Ellie and Pocoyo are going to have a race to see who's faster. I think Pato wants to get things going. So what are you going to say to get the race started, Pato? Yes, you say ready, steady, and then what comes next, Pato? Oh dear, Pato can't remember what comes next. Can any of you help Pato to get the race started? Say it with me. Ready, steady,
go!
And they're off! Well done, isn't it thrilling? Pocoyo and Ellie are neck and neck. Oh, and I think they've woken Sleepy Bird. Oh, and look, it seems as though she wants to join the race as well. Although, it doesn't look like she can go very fast. It looks as though Ellie is taking the lead. Oh no, what bad luck! Ellie appears to be stuck in the sand. And there goes Pocoyo, leaving poor Ellie in the dust. I mean sand. Wait a moment. Looks like Ellie has an idea. What's she going to do? She's pulling herself out. Pull, Ellie, pull! She did it! And she's off again! Nice going, Pocoyo! You're way ahead! You're working up quite a sweat, aren't you? Oh, my. This is very strange. What are you doing now, Pocoyo?
Ice cream.
You're eating an ice cream in the middle of the race? Well, I must say, you must be feeling pretty confident if you're eating ice cream. Oh, Ellie. Well, you'd better get going if you want to win the race, Pocoyo. He's off again! Look at that Pocoyo go! Oh, and there's Sleepy Bird! Pocoyo and Ellie are neck and neck again! What a race! Oh no, what was that? It looks like the car and scooter have fallen apart and so close to the finish. Oh dear, how are Pocoyo and Ellie going to finish the race without a car or scooter? You know, I wonder if there's a way you might still be able to finish the race. Just think, Pocoyo. You have a bit that still works, and Ellie, you have another bit. Is there a way you can make a new vehicle, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo and Ellie work out how they could make something new?
Together! Put them together!
Yes, if you put each of your pieces together, you can finish the race together in style. Look at that! Pocoyo and Ellie have made a caruta. Perfect! It appears that you both won the race together. Oh, well, actually, it seems that Sleepy Bird is the winner. I suppose it just goes to show. It's really not who gets to the finish line first that matters. The fun is all in how you get there. And with whom. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo. What's this? It looks like a... Oh, that's strange. It certainly is a nice bright colour. Can any of you tell what colour it is?
It's red!
That's right! It's red! Oops! It looks like you'll have to catch it first. But that could be difficult. Perhaps it just wants to play, Pocoyo. Now, Pocoyo, it's not as bad as all that. Yes, I understand that you're frustrated, but... Did it just speak? It did speak! Perhaps someone should reply to it.
Me!
You, Pocoyo? Ah, now it's your turn, Pato. That doesn't seem to be working.
Don't That's
better. Oh my! Where did it go? Do you think it might come back if we all call out, "Where are you?" Good. Ready? Where are you? Once again. Where are you? Could we do better than that, Pocoyo?
Lotta.
Once again. Where are you? Yes, yes, Pocoyo. It was right there. Your new friend is certainly mischievous, Pocoyo. This must be another friend. And another one. How many shapes does that make? Let's count them. One, two, three. Hello, Ellie. It seems your new friend wants to tell you something, Pocoyo. Is that right? Ah, the dancing must have given him an idea. I wonder what they're planning. It looks as if they have a surprise in store. Lovely music. Hooray for Pocoyo! And hooray for finding new ways to play. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pato. Now, what on earth is that? Can any of you tell Pato what that is?
It's an egg, Pato.
It's a big egg.
Ah, you're right. I see. It is an egg. Fascinating. Oh, hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Ball? Oh, dear, but... No, Pocoyo, you and Ellie have the wrong idea here. You see, that's not really a ball. What Pato has is an egg.
very soon something will happen to that egg. It will hatch. Now do you see why that egg is so special to Pato? Oh dear, it's time, it's time. It's... It's a spider! I suppose ducklings aren't the only things that hatch from eggs. And some people are frightened of spiders, even baby ones. I'm afraid you've given Pato a fright, baby spider. Baby spider isn't that scary, Pato. And he seems to like you. There's Pocoyo and Ellie.
Hello!
Oh dear. I reckon they're still too scared to play with you as long as baby spider is around. Baby spider, Papa Pato, has a game he wants to play. He wants you to count all the stones you can find. I suppose you can go and play with Pocoyo and Ellie now, Pato. Ah, baby spider found a stone. Papa Pato says keep counting. Pato, what baby spider would like to do?
Play ball.
Play!
I think you're right. He wants to play. Hello, baby bird. Pato says, take the pencil and go and do some colouring, baby spider. What's this? Can any of you tell Ellie and Pocoyo who did that nice drawing of them? You're right. Aw, that's so sweet. See? I knew once you got to know each other, you'd all be the best of friends. Hooray for Pato! Hooray for new friends! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello.
What's that sound? Hello. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to scare you. Oh, no, of course, I understand. You weren't frightened. Not a bit, no. So, where are you off to? You're looking for Pocoyo's World? Really? Well, we know how to get to Pocoyo's World. Why, certainly. We'd be happy to show you the way. What's so funny? Nothing. Right, well, can all of you tell the alien the way to get to Pocoyo's World?
That way!
Follow the arrow!
Yes, it's that way. Follow the arrow. And have a safe trip. Here we are! By the way, you do come in peace, don't you? No? Oh, dear. Oh, no. Seems like the alien has an evil plan for taking over Pocoyo's World. Oh, but look, he's only little. Oh, how cute. Caterpillar says, thanks for the hat, Mr. Alien. The alien says he's here to be king, Caterpillar, not to make hats. Pocoyo? I want to introduce you to this little alien who's come here to... Not exactly. It seems he's here to make himself king of your planet.
Ellie!
Hello, Ellie! Can any of you tell Ellie and Pocoyo where that sound is coming from?
From the alien! Stepped on him.
Yes, that's right. Oh, dear. There you are. Oh, dear. Squished. Ah, good as new. Aww. Maybe you'd like to play a little before you conquer the planet, Mr. Alien? Oh, dear. Pato, the alien says he commands you to move those flowers to the left. Pato agrees, little alien. The flowers do look much nicer there. He's happy you told him what to do. You say that's your side of the fence, and no one is allowed to go over there. Look, you can all have fun jumping. Look out, Ellie! The alien is trying to scare you, Ellie. Oh, and now the little toy cannon is broken. no, little alien, don't. It's not that bad. Maybe you should stop conquering for a while and just be friends. We'll be your friends, as long as you're friendly, right? Will you be friends with the alien if he's friendly? All you have to do is be friendly. Ah, now that's better. You may not have conquered the world, little alien, but you have certainly conquered our hearts. Hooray for playing nicely. Hooray for new friends. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Insert coin. That looks like a lovely tea party you're having, Ellie. Who's your friend? Ah, Daisy. Very nice to meet you, Daisy. Well, hello, angry alien. Did you come to join Ellie and Daisy's tea party? Ellie's right, Pocoyo. Angry Alien has kidnapped Daisy. Dear Pocoyo, you lost. Yes, this trophy is really nice, but don't forget your mission. Get up to the other side. Pocoyo, look! A power-up! Well done! You beat the level! Look, Pocoyo! A key! Maybe if you lull Sleepy Bird to sleep... Pocoyo! That lullaby is terrible. Maybe you should get some help.
Mm-hmm.
Run! Now's your chance. Be careful. This level looks difficult. Remember, you still have one last power-up. The next time you want something, you just need to ask for it nicely.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Hello, Pato. Hello, Ellie. And what are our little friends up to today? Did you hear that? Oh, look! It's our friend Octopus. Hello, Octopus. Oh, and look what he's got with him. Can any of you tell Pocoyo, Pato and Ellie what Octopus is carrying?
A bat and a ball!
Yes, he's got a bat and ball with him. And it looks like Octopus has a great idea. Everyone can play bat and ball. Octopus is all set to play. Who's going to bat? Ah, it looks like Pato has the first turn, Pocoyo. Oh, don't worry, Pocoyo. Everyone will have a turn to bat the ball. Ellie, you'll have to wait for your go too. Poor Pato. Now, what can that be? It's Octopus! He's winding up and... Wait! I think it is! Yes! It's the Whipping Windmill Whopper! Well, that's one way to hit the ball, Pato. Great job, Pocoyo. Bringing the ball back is a very important job, especially when we only have one ball. It looks like Ellie is going to bat now. After all, she was waiting too, remember? But don't worry, Pocoyo, you'll be next.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, what a hit! I knew she'd work out how to do it sooner or later. It's going. It still seems to be going. Now, where's it gone?
Why, it's Sleepy Bird. Maybe she's seen the ball.
Ball!
Well, that's closer, Pocoyo. But, can all of you help Pocoyo again? Is that his ball?
No!
It's an egg, Pocoyo!
Well, that's odd. A snowman and some snowballs. I wonder whose team he's on. Well, do you see the ball anywhere, Pocoyo? Wait, do you hear that? What's that sound? What was that? What happened? I think the ball just came down. Did you see it, Pocoyo? What about all of you? Did any of you see where the ball landed?
By the snowman!
Ball!
You've got it! It's that one! Great job, Pocoyo!
Boring.
And now, at last, it's Pocoyo's turn to bat. Remember, Pocoyo, keep your eye on the ball. What a hit! Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for having your turn. Right, let's go and get that ball now. Bye. See you soon. There's Pocoyo, Pato and Ellie. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Ah, it's a dressing up box. So, what do you think you'd like to do today? Do any of you know?
Dressing up.
Dressing up.
Ah, yes. What a good idea.
Story, story.
What's that? You would like me to tell a story? And you will all pretend to be the characters? Oh, that would be great fun. And I think it's safe to say that I'm rather a good storyteller. You all get ready now.
Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, there lived a brave young prince. Oh, dear.
Wait. The prince is the one who has a crown.
Can any of you tell me which one of our friends is the prince?
Pocoyo!
Yes, it's Pocoyo. Sorry, boys. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. Now, this young prince was called Prince Pocoyo.
Hooray!
And he was very brave. And very handsome. And strong. Oh, and tall, of course.
Yes.
But this prince wasn't alone in his kingdom.
Oh, no.
There was also a beautiful elephant princess who had... No birds. Thank you, baby bird. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Anyway, she was without doubt the sweetest and most charming creature in the universe. So dainty and beautiful and strong.
Yes, well that's very impressive, Ellie. I say, this isn't quite the story I was expecting to tell. But I think a weightlifting princess will work out very well indeed. Now, where were we? Ah, yes. This delicate and dainty elephant princess loved the prince. And the prince loved her. Ah, this isn't going so badly after all. But she was desperately sad because she couldn't go out to play with Prince Pocoyo because a crazy duck would not let her. He was a cruel and crazy... Come on. Oh, do come on, Pato. You're supposed to be the baddie. Look, I promise you can be the prince next time. All right? Please? I promise. Good. So, this crazy duck was really cruel and crazy. More crazy? Just a little bit more crazy, Pato. Ah, that's perfect. Thank you, Pato. So, when he saw the young prince approaching, he decided to frighten him away forever with his fierce, terrifying, fire-breathing dragon. Yes! Who jumped towards the prince and started to kiss him. Oh, dear. After this, the crazy duck was so furious, he sent his best warrior, the sleeping knight, and his terrible army. Hello again, baby bird. This time, Prince Pocoyo was surrounded. No escape. What could he do? Invite them all to a picnic? Why did I ask? And to have a little sleep in his bed? But Crazy Duck was really angry with him, so angry that he started to water his plants. And the elephant princess went for a ride on her scooter. Ellie, but this is not a... And Prince Pocoyo played in his car, and the crazy duck bought himself a canary, and... Oh, wait a moment. Now I get it. Yes. Once upon a time, there were some great friends who just love playing together. What a wonderful story. Hooray for stories. And hooray for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon. It's Pocoyo, Ellie and Baby Bird. Hello.
Hello.
Ellie is reading a book. What are you up to, Pocoyo? Oh, can't you think of anything to do?
Boring.
Don't be silly. There's always loads of fun to be had. Why don't you find something to play with? What about a game of catch?
Play!
Wow! What do you think, Ellie? Would you like to play catch? What was that? Can you tell Pocoyo what made that noise?
The ball
in the dustbin.
I believe you're right. What a terrific sound it makes. What have you got there, Pocoyo?
More noise.
Oh, terrific. Wonderful. Let's all clap along, shall we?
Hi, Pato! Come and make some noise with us!
Are you trying to take a nap?
We'll be very quiet.
Oh, Ellie, Pocoyo. Your music is, well, quite lively, but Pato is trying to sleep. Sorry, Pato.
Ah, look! You could play with these quietly. Oh, Ellie, maybe you shouldn't... Oh, dear. Wait!
Can any of you tell our friends why Pato can't sleep?
Noise!
They're making too much noise!
Noisy!
Well, it won't happen again, Pato. We'll be nice and quiet. What's this? A radio? The phone? A television? A washing machine? An alarm clock? What are you going to do with... Oh, no. Perhaps it's all too far away for Pato to hear. Oh, dear. Listen, Pato... I'm afraid we've done it again. Poor Pato. How is he ever going to get to sleep? What's this?
Lullaby!
I see. You want to send Pato to sleep with music. Let's all count to three.
One, two, three.
Pocoyo! Pocoyo! Pocoyo!
Sorry, that wasn't very soothing, I'm afraid. Well, you can't blame them, Pato. They did try. Perhaps they need help in order to play quietly. Ah, so you're a conductor, Pato. Lovely. Oh, Pato? Pato? Don't you want to sleep anymore? Oh, dear. Oh, well. Hooray for making music. Hooray for playing together. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
I I see that you've got a brand new toy. What is it, Pocoyo? Do any of you know what Pocoyo's new toy is?
It's a plane!
It's an aeroplane!
Yes, that's right!
Plane!
Oh, Pocoyo loves his new toy plane. I wonder why he loves it so much. Oh, I think he's going to show us why. It looks like Ellie wants a turn flying the plane. Do you know how to make it fly, Ellie? That's right, you wind it up. But don't wind it up too much, Ellie.
Uh-oh. Plane, plane, no!
Look how high it's going. Oh, we've lost Pocoyo's plane. How can we find it if we can't even see it? Telescope! What a good idea, Pato! When you look through a telescope, you can see things that are far away. Quick, Pocoyo, look through the telescope! Well, it looks like the plane flew all the way up to outer space. How will we ever get up to outer space to get it back? Oh, of course, the vamoosh! Aliens. Don't be afraid. Oh, what fun! But what about your toy plane, Pocoyo? Maybe the aliens know where it is.
Airplane.
I don't think you can reach it up there, Pocoyo. And nor can Ellie or Pato. Do you know anyone who could reach it, Pocoyo? I don't know. Maybe, or just maybe, someone very stretchy. Can any of you see someone who can stretch right up and help Pocoyo get his plane?
The alien!
Yay! Our new alien friend did it! Hooray! Oh, I think the aliens want to say something. Let's have a party.
Yay!
Terrific idea. By finding his plane, Pocoyo has found some new friends too. How splendid! Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Oh, look, Pocoyo. It's someone's birthday today. Do you know whose birthday it is, Pocoyo? So? Oh, I see. You want us to work it out for ourselves, like a guessing game. So, can any of you guess whose birthday it is?
Ellie!
It's Ellie's birthday!
Yes, you're right. Today is Ellie's birthday. And she's having a party later. It's very exciting. But Pocoyo, have you got Ellie a birthday present yet?
No.
Well, what are you going to get?
Make one.
Oh, I see. What a great idea. You're going to make a present for Ellie. But, Pocoyo, what are you going to make? Do you know? So? Oh, I see. It's another guessing game. We have to work it out. What fun. Well, the party begins very soon, so I suppose you'd better get started, Pocoyo. Pocoyo! What are you doing here, Pocoyo? Oh, I see. You're going to make the present for Ellie out of all these lovely shapes. That's a good idea. I wonder what it's going to be. Oh, that's a good start. A lovely big pink ball. That's wonderful, Pocoyo, but what is it? I see. You haven't finished yet. Oh, I can't wait to find out what it is. This is so exciting. Are those going to go on your present too? Oh, I wonder what Pocoyo's present is going to be. Guess now. Ah, let me see. It's big, it's pink, and it's a present for Ellie, so it needs to be something Ellie really likes. Something missing. Now, what bit of Ellie is it that's missing, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo work it out? What's missing from Ellie?
Ellie's trunk!
That's it. Well done. Ellie needs a trunk. So put it on then, Pocoyo. Do you know where it goes? Pocoyo, do you think that's really the right place for Ellie's trunk? Oh, I see you're playing. What fun. Oh, that does look funny, Pocoyo. But where does Ellie's trunk really go? Perfect. Well, isn't that marvellous? Pocoyo has made a wonderful Ellie for Ellie. And just in time for her party. Come on, it's time to go.
Happy birthday, Ellie!
You're welcome.
It was from us too, you know. You're very, very welcome, Ellie. It was our pleasure.
Happy birthday, Ellie.
Let's all say happy birthday too.
Happy birthday, Ellie!
Bye! See you soon!